The system is setting us up for failure. They're stretching it out to the maximum. They're milking us to the last drop. The destruction of small businesses has been well coordinated and well executed. The virus has killed more small businesses than actual people. Retail closures are exploding. So much easier for the politicians to control if there is only Amazon and Walmart. Real household income is the lowest that it has been in a decade. Poverty is absolutely soaring. 47 million Americans are on food stamps, and the middle class is being systematically destroyed. How can big corporations be doing so well while most American families are having such a hard time? In the United States, the 400 richest individuals now own more wealth than the bottom 64% of the population, and the three richest own more wealth than the bottom 50%, while pervasive poverty means one in five households have zero or negative net worth. Small business is being strangled to death. And the regulatory environment for small businesses is more suffocating than it has ever been before. With the mass panic of the pandemic, fear is causing businesses to close doors and our economy to take a major slump in what feels like the beginning of a zombie apocalypse. Add this to the economic terrorism imposed on small businesses and the middle class. It is health insurance renewal season. If you are aged the 50s to 60s, most plans' annual event all-in cost is $25,000 to $35,000. The median household income in the USA is $68,703. So, approximately 35% to 50% of household income is captured by the oligarchic monopolistic medical industry. Add 30% for income and payroll tax. Add 22% for housing. We are watching the destruction of the middle class. And no one is even trying to stop it. Large businesses have no trouble, they can still run and operate. It's the mom and pop small businesses that can't do any business safely in pandemic time. They are killing small business. The number of self-employed Americans is now lower than it was 10 years ago. Small businesses have traditionally been one of the main engines of economic growth in this country. The American economy is less entrepreneurial now than at any point in the last three decades. When the big corporate chains and Bezos are major political contributors, what do you expect? What exactly is the huge difference between food shopping or being in Walmart and going into a restaurant to get takeout? The answer is nothing, especially with non-N95 masks. It's like stopping dust with a chain-link fence. You know those Congress critters that you vote for each election cycle to represent you? They are the ones carrying out these orders from their paymasters. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. You are here for your daily dose of the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Please take a second to click the like button. And don't forget to smash the bell button in order to get a notification whenever a new video is uploaded. Thank you. The curve still isn't flat yet. More small businesses have to die as a sacrifice. The totalitarian measures are designed to crush the small and benefit the large, while the balance sheets of US billionaires and major corporations grew to over $1 trillion from March of this year through October, as many Americans are barely scraping to get by. They need some stimulus. More payroll protection loans likely to be again mismanaged to include corporations and felons in prison. Of the $908 billion stimulus plan proposed and currently negotiating with both parties, no stimulus for the people is included. Here we go, folks, the political class taking care of itself and completely overlooking the people. Election over, they have our votes. We won't hear from any of them until next election. Once all small businesses are bankrupted, then Amazon, Walmart can set whatever prices they want, and you'll have no other choice. The only way to stop politicians from doing what Amazon, Walmart, and Big Pharma lobbyists tell them to do is to support small businesses now more than ever. Let us hope that one of the unintended consequences of this travesty will be to rile the middle class into a wrathful movement to stop the oligarchs. This happened in Germany 90 years ago when the average person lost his entire life's savings from hyperinflation. The oligarchs of the day swept in to buy most everything up for pfennigs on the mark. We all know what popular revolution resulted from this rape of the German people. It's a class war. But instead of the poor rising up against the capitalists, It's the elites waging a war of attrition on the poor and small business owners. There's a defect in the human race, preventing people from understanding the situation of other people until they get into the same situation themselves. That's why politicians just cannot understand that this is any different for people than it is for themselves. It's a planned move to pure fascism, a joint government of politicians and big business. Government passes the laws and regulations big business wants, and big business manages the propaganda, finances, and labor employment of the serving population, one ring to rule them all. The freedom to form your own small business, compete more efficiently with big business, acquire property and capital, and become financially independent cannot be allowed. If the state and central banks were put out of business, then peace and harmony would reign supreme, freedom, and liberty for all. The undergoing plan of the annihilation of small businesses is the greatest theft in American history. As we all know, less competition means higher prices. Current policies are destroying small businesses. Bubbling up to the surface is the recognition the Fed has played a major role in pushing inequality higher. When it was suggested the Fed and Treasury Department lower the minimum size of the loans under the Main Street Lending Program to $100,000 from the current $250,000 to help a larger number of small companies that have been hurt by the pandemic, Powell even went so far as to claim there was little demand for loans below $1 million. The oligarchs want them destroyed to ease the transition to totalitarianism. The purpose of the this psyop is twofold. First, to conceal the bank cartel's complicity in our economic destruction with fiat currency and a debt-based economy. Second, to ensure the economic health of themselves and their minions in the 0.1% by extracting what wealth the 99.9% have left. The plan is to keep the Phase 2 lockdown in place for a much longer period of time than the Phase 1 lockdown, continuing to destroy the global economy. Further degrade the supply chain and further amplify food shortages and the like. Quell any public outrage using extreme actions or force and make anyone who defies them appear as public enemy number one to those who are willing to submit. Government at all levels sees businesses as nothing more than cash cows to bully, extort, rape, and exploit. Have you ever noticed that, whenever a local TV news station or newspaper announces, with great fanfare, the opening up or relocation of a new business to the local area, the very first thing they observe, in addition to the creation of local jobs, i.e., more tax cash cows for the local nanny thugs to exploit, is that the business will bring more tax revenues to the city-county coffers? No one ever observes that the businesses are providing a good or service that the buying public wants and is willing to purchase with its own money, thus creating local economic growth for its own sake and thus enhancing individual freedom of choice and overall well-being. It's that businesses are contributing to, usually defined as giving back to, a sickeningly collectivist term, that ill-defined and nonsensical community. No wonder no one is launching new businesses above ground, in the legitimate economy. Only a complete fool would even dream of doing so under current conditions. Many operate from insecurity, creating a need for control. That competition within this population would result in superstitious tribes led by sociopaths, pitting tribe against tribe, should not be a surprise. We will never be as intelligent as the universe. America was a bait and swap from the beginning. Ignore the Declaration of Independence and the Bill of Rights. What remains is corporate law, control resources, create a sense of scarcity, and efficiently extract monopoly profits. If I can control demographics, I care not who prints the money or writes the laws. The system is built on a foundation of family, common law with no due process, supporting corporate law. And automation has then been inserted under the council, empire by force. The chameleons proffer empire by diplomacy, a false choice, as the pandemic response demonstrates. Don't play, or play to win. Marriage under God is the former, but the latter is relevant to most. It's been a complex system problem all along. The economy is built from the bottom up, and after a few generations, those at the top start chasing efficiency, their own tail. We are interested in an algorithm and data structure for simultaneous reorganizations among complex systems. A good place to start is an income statement array of arrays, withholding company balance sheet inquiries capable of both quantitative and qualitative metrics. The Nexus is the project manager, melding fact with mythology. That's why they are called Special Projects Coordinators. The process is cut up into three parts: off-sheet asset acquisition, reorganization, and special ops. The military-industrial complex is like the main artery feeding cancerous tissue. The military-industrial complex grows regardless of party, and the party tribes are essentially mobs. Real estate and the financial markets are just money laundering operations. Of course, the owners want to see a Gantt chart from the balance sheet perspective, but that isn't how it's really done. The whole point was to wipe out small businesses. They are quite inconvenient. Society will develop a new kind of servitude which covers the surface of society with a network of complicated rules through which the most original minds and the most energetic characters cannot penetrate. It does not tyrannize, but it compresses, enervates, extinguishes, and stupefies a people till each nation is reduced to nothing better than a flock of timid and industrious animals, of which the government is the shepherd.